Hey, what's going on out there? I'm Sean Devine. Hope you all are doing well. Today, I've got a quick video where I wanted to go over my new MacBook Pro-based studio setup. As you can see here, I no longer have my 2010 iMac, which you guys are familiar. You've seen it in the videos. It went 10 years strong. It was still working, was having some issues. But most importantly, when the Logic Pro X 10.5 update came out recently, I found out that you had to have a newer OS, and it turns out that Apple actually stopped supporting the hardware on that 2010 iMac. So not only was I not able to get Logic Pro X 10.5 on there, I also can't even get the latest OS, which means that, you know, all the software, all the hardware was extremely outdated. So what we've got here is my MacBook Pro. I've had this for a few years now. This is a 2016. I'll put all the specs to it below, but it is the same specs on paper, you know, quad core, 16 gigs of RAM, very similar to my existing iMac. However, we've got Catalina running on here. And then we have Thunderbolt 3 connectivity, which we'll talk about in a minute why that's made a big difference here. But for me, this is a really different sort of workflow. I was a little nervous about, you know, starting to try to work strictly off of this and implement it into the same setup. But again, as you can see in here, all of my gear is all interfaced the same way with the iMac, except we're going through a single Thunderbolt 3 connection. And I'll show you how I've got that set up. It's actually a hub that I did some research on by a company called CalDigit. I'll put links to all this stuff, but I wanted something that I wasn't gonna have all these crazy adapters and, you know, just different types of connectivity. If we're gonna be Thunderbolt 3, I wanted it all to be Thunderbolt 3 so that I'm getting that speed and performance out of the hard drives, you know, anything that's hooked up. So with that hub, I am not only able to get Thunderbolt 3 connections for all of my SSDs, I also have, you know, an SD card for, you know, the video. I have Ethernet. I have HDMI for the external monitor. There's all kinds of different stuff there. So again, all I have to do is just hook up the monitor with that one cable to the hub. And, you know, when I want to take this on the go, when travel starts letting up again, you know, I can just take this and have everything here that I would be using in my normal studio setup. Now, as you all know, with the iMac, I had two setups. So that had its advantages, but it also was a little bit convoluted in terms of trying to keep those machines consistent. But this way, you know, I do like the fact that this is the main system, and when I take it out of the studio, it's going to be identical to what I'm working with, you know, minus the fact that I won't have some of the hardware with me. So a thing I like about this is that I can have the MacBook screen up and I can use that as an additional monitor. So, you know, let's just say, for instance, we wanted to have, you know, some kind of monitoring or maybe, you know, Ozone mastering plugin or something like that open here. You know, I can just drag that over, keep that open, leave the real estate for, you know, my faders and all that stuff over here on the other side. Now, also, I can just close this and use this monitor exclusively. So it just gives you some flexibility. And I haven't been able to work off of dual screen in a long time. It's been a serious workflow enhancement in terms of, you know, mixing in the DAW. So the other thing I mentioned with the iMac that was starting to really weigh me down was the connectivity. So I was using USB 2.0 FireWire, and even though I had USB 3.0 or even some Thunderbolt capable SSDs and other peripherals, none of that was able to utilize the bandwidth because my iMac couldn't support it. So now with purely Thunderbolt 3 connection, everything is running at the speed it should, which means all my drives are performing better. You know, even my sound drives, you know, the session drives, everything is just loading much more snappy. The performance in the DAW, even though this is the same specs as my iMac, it just feels like a completely new machine with a lot more power. So one thing I'm not loving about it is the laptop. You know, when you're running this as a screen, you're capturing video like I am right now, and you're running the DAW, which I do in a lot of my tutorials, this thing runs hot. and a lot hotter than my iMac, and the fans tend to go pretty consistently. So there's actually a couple of apps that I found that have been really helpful with this. You know, you don't want to turn off those fans because that will, you know, ultimately damage the Mac. But if you're like me and you're in a studio environment, you know, having a quiet environment and you can hear the fans going right now. If you're trying to record and that's important to you, you don't want to hear that going, you can use something like TG Pro, which is this app that I found, and I'll put links to these, but you can monitor the temperature of, you know, all your CPUs, the battery, you know, your graphics card. And then what we can actually do is go in here and we can set our preferences for, you know, like how much we want the fans to be on and at what temperature and how fast we want them to go. So you can actually slow it down to where it's not gonna be as noisy, but it'll still keep your computer cool. Now, I do want to again warn you, just be careful about how you're setting this. Do a little research. It has a couple of suggestions for different options for you, but you can just kind of set these thresholds of temperature and how fast the fans are actually going to turn. You can see my computer obviously is running pretty hot right now, close to 85 Celsius. When you get towards 90, you know, that's where you kind of want to be concerned about. But again, that's just because we're doing all this stuff at once right now. The other app that is really cool is called Turbo Booster Pro. And what this will do is with, you know, the newer MacBooks, the newer Apple computers, you have what's called Turbo Boost in an Intel processor. And when that kicks in, it tends to make your fans turn on immediately because your computer's working that much harder to get the performance. So what we can actually do is disable Turbo Boost completely. Now, again, this is not something that's available out of the box on your Mac. There's probably a reason for that, so be careful with it. But I've been using it just when I don't need the extra speed. You know, if I'm working in a session that there's not a ton going on, then I can just disable that and it's not gonna have those fans going constantly, especially when I'm recording these tutorials with you guys. So yeah, guys, I think that covers the new MacBook laptop setup for me in the studio. Thus far, you know, as much hesitation as I had with this, I have been liking it. And once I kind of got going with it, I just said, you know what, I'm just going to commit to this because this is, you know, the future of, you know, my workflow and really the connectivity with Thunderbolt 3 and all that. We're headed that way anyway, so I just figured it was time. And you know, I like the fact that I can just take this on the go and have the exact setup. I don't have to worry about keeping two machines consistent anymore, but I'm still obviously, you know, doing duplicate backups, backups to the cloud, which again, I just want to stress, use this as an opportunity to make sure you guys back up before you're talking about doing any OS updates or going to the new Logic Pro. That was definitely something that I was doing. And it's been a little bit of work to get all this implemented, but so far so good, and hopefully it'll set me up for the next 10 years like the iMac did. It was a great computer, but yeah, time to get into 2020 and into the new technology, so I'm learning a lot. Unfortunately, I did have to replace a couple of things that weren't compatible, but as far as like the main hardware, you know, even my other USB 3.0 hub, all that stuff is implemented the exact same way. It's just replaced the iMac with a laptop. But if you have any questions about how I put this together and how it's interfacing here with all the rest of, you know, my MIDI controllers and my monitoring and all that, feel free to leave a comment below. And if you have any suggestions, this is a new setup for me, so for those of you out there who have been working in this kind of way, feel free to leave us some feedback. Definitely love to hear about it. If you learned anything in the video, please like, subscribe, and consider sharing. We'll talk to you soon. Been going through it lately, testing my patience, this world wants to break me down. Some of you seeking, I'm giving fruits of the labor, y'all flexing, I'm living aloud, aging like fine wine. I'm counting these pennies, place the highest values on my time, try to be a son of the Most High, reflect brightness and contrast and low.